Sudan grass. They were just like 2 inches high when I left 16 days ago. Now it's all of 4 feet. It's supposed to secrete a substance that other grasses don't like, especially crabgrass. So what I'm hoping it does is any grasses that are growing from a lawn into that, that it just stifles them. The next year this is going to be a great bed to grow something on. And here's one service tree, doing pretty good. You can see the soil looks moist. We did get a deer clip on that, so we'll have to think about a cage. The other one is over here. This is a wild rose right here, and there it is. Ooh, it's growing some new leaves on the top. It likes it here next to these wild roses. Of course, serviceberry is part of the rose family. So that makes sense, right? Planted by some wild roses because it's part of the rose family. Those wild roses will take care of it until it starts to take care of them. One more over here. Not growing new leaves, but it looks exceptionally healthy. It likes it here between the seaberry bushes. Seaberries look like they're happy this year too. They weren't happy 3 weeks ago. Anyway, we got our, this is our one without much, that's not a thorn, it's just a little limpy thing here. This is our one without thorns on it. Easy to harvest. Yum yum. This is like my 50th one already. They're all over. I haven't had a good year like this for a couple of years. Alright, the Nanking cherries are ripe. I get to pick a bunch of those too. Look at that. Bumper crop year. Ooh, they're good and sweet this year. Awesome. Here is the spot where a buck was making a scrape, and he was rubbing on this branch right here, and look, he's still hanging around. Ooh, and these acorns are still hanging around too. Ooh, normally they're falling off by now. Last year there was like a dozen or two. There's a lot on the tree this year, so hopefully they hang on. More food for the deer. I planted this swamp white oak as a big box clearance in August. In the year 2000, I think. Pretty sure. And another one he broke off, and another one he broke off. Well, maybe not this one. But look at all those acorns are hanging on. Normally I get to pull most of them off. Bumper crop. Yeah, that thing's all at 20 feet high now. That is a little baby fawn print. Now it's still alive. Yeah, we've definitely got enough rain. Those grasses with the red stalks is wild rice. Growing out of water, although it's right next to it. I've had that happen in the past. Some over there too. Last fall for the deer to eat, and looks like we're going to have seed we can replant. And hidden inside are three types of clovers and a chicory. Seeded that in. It's growing up with the wild plants. I like thistles, I like to have them grow. Last year I had mustard in here. And the deer loved it. Just look at that lush growth of that clover in there. Under the canopy of winter rye. So here we have more clover. Not as much winter rye. And it looks good. The deer, when they have the munchies, they're going to show up. Definitely in October. I planted honey locusts 16 days ago. They came to me, they were in a refrigerator as a stick and a root. I stuck it in the ground. 16 days later, and they're making some leaves. I would like them to grow here at the 4 o'clock sun to shade this pond. And here is the cave corn three sisters. Cave corn, cave beans, and two types of Native American squash. I gotta try to get hold of that squash next year for that grows, that came from 1500 years ago too. That's doing fabulous. The corn better hurry because the squash is gonna grow right up over the top of it. I'm not too worried. So there, this was really thick layer of compost. Here was a very thin layer of compost. Tell the difference? Sunflowers are really growing. If I didn't have this cage around it, the deer would be in here feasting. I think I'm gonna have to get in there before I leave and cut a few leaves off that squash. Give the corn some sunlight. Ooh, I didn't think I had climbing beans in here. Oh, they are. There's a few growing on the property here, not too many. Oh, I lost it. Got it. This is the wintergreen I planted 16 days ago, and it's blossoming. That looks nice. There's another one right there. Another one right there. That's a nanny berry in a cage. Elderberry in the backdrop. Chicory and clover is growing around it that I planted by seed. I wanted the deer to come in here and eat on these sunchokes, and lordy lordy, are they ever doing it. All of these are chewed. Chewed, I got a whole bunch of them in here, all chewed. But artichokes can really take it. You just keep right on growing. Little buffet for the deer in here. There's chicory and three types of clovers and a bunch of garden plants I put in here, garden seeds. Flatten this spot right here. At some point I'll put some straw or something on it and we'll see if they bet on it. Ooh, they're eating on the skirret. Yeah, that's a skirret plant that they're eating. That's good. I put this cage here so they can't eat it right down to the ground. They don't get this food out in the forest. So they're gonna keep coming. For one deal in here is a little bitty hazelnut doing very well. And I've got a Hascap right above it. Oh, is that a Hascap? Yeah, it's got a brown, but yeah, I think it is. They look good. That Hascap looks pretty nice. You know, when you think about them being in that nursery all taken care of so nicely, and then they got to come out here into the wild, it's amazing any of them live. I'll take care of them. I don't think I have to water this time. Got some good rains. Finally. So I won't be exhausted watering them this time. Oh, those two hazelnuts look very nice. This blackberry. Showing off. I don't know what I got in that tube. Yeah, it looks like a hornet. I think it's a bald-faced hornet and a goldenrod. Bent down those goldenrods for the morning sun to come in here a little better. Help out that hazelnut, and I think this is an apricot right here. I don't remember planting it, but I'm going to pretend it's an apricot until it tells me it isn't. I did plant a lot of northern apricots up here. This might be one of them that made it. I did that like 10 years ago. little bitty teeny seedlings. So I have to find a cage. I'll put a cage around both of these two since they're so close. Two for one. Oh, look at that big old bear scat right there. I think, unless that's a deer. No, that's got to be bear scat. That's huge. Unless it's a big old buck. No, there's hair in it. That's got to be a. It's got to be bear scat. Right here in the row that I planted hazelnuts and hascaps. Hazelnut is getting crowded out by the weeds. I don't even like them touching it. I think them getting touched even bothers them. So I cleared it all the way here. And I lay it down on the ground in front of them on the sun side. The mulch. I don't have to buy straw up here. Unless I feel real lazy. Take a couple of these on the morning sun side so the morning sun can get in here. I think this is a wild clover and it's going to seed. Well, you know what? We should tuck it. Oh, here's another tree that I don't remember. I think this is one of those plums. Rootstock plums. I also planted some rootstock cherry in here. You tell me. Is that cherry or is that plum? I left the windows on the car open and look at. I better start heading back just in case it starts to pour. Our heat waves are definitely over for now. When I saw all of those lawns in the city that I drove through to get here, they were all green. I thought, yep, all those rains that it looked like were going through here landed on the wild land too. You put some sort of cage around this, these apples, so that they don't fall to the ground. Sure like to know what they taste like. Even though this flat dried up, I can see wild rice growing in here. See some right there, all those leaves there, and those are all wild rice inside the cage too. Something's been rolling through, you see all the reeds are down. I'll get some boots on, I'll walk in there tomorrow maybe. Last year this crabapple tree had a few apples and I didn't see them until December, and they were all blooded. I ate them, they were so sweet, I couldn't believe it. This year, there's apples all over. Crazy. This is a spot where I grew hascaps, or planted hascaps. I got radishes and other things planted in there. And I think it's gone a little crazy. This might be that Hollis oats right here. Good thing I can see that and I can leave those in, because I'm going to have to weed this before I leave. I don't really know if there's a hascap in there. I see one right there. I don't know, that's a clover. A big old radish. I'm going to have to take the cage off and just go through it very carefully. Here's a nice spring radish. Look at that, nice big one. I'll be going home with a lot of stuff. I don't have gutters up here yet, so I just line up the buckets. I put those sticks in there in case something gets in there that could drown otherwise. Tie them up. I had some carcass beetles in here last time, I thought, I don't want to kill any carcass beetles. Not as many of those around anymore. There's been rain, look at that. The ground is so hard from being dried up that it's not going to soak in for a while.